Hi, I'm Bill with Plugged In Golf. Today we're going to talk about the Nike VaporSpeed irons. Let's get plugged in. The Nike VaporSpeed irons are genuinely one of the best, if not the best, game improvement irons I've seen to date. In addition to being a great golf club, they're really good looking and really prove that they belong with the best of the best in the industry. When you think of Nike, you definitely think of good looking equipment. Their aesthetics are something they're known for throughout all of athletics, let's face it. But these golf clubs, I feel like it's a true, coming to form for Nike in terms of living up to the reputation they have. It's still a flashy looking golf club. It has a bright neon Volt swoosh, minimal branding on it, but very nice structured lines that say, hey, this is a high class golf club. In terms of being a game improvement club, it does have a little bit of a thicker sole, but it's not offensively in an inappropriately large size. The top line, same thing. It is a little thicker. It's not quite the size of a forged blade, but again, it's not super fat. You'd be really, really, really hard pressed to go, oh, that's a standard game improvement iron. It's a really good looking golf club. When I first hit the VaporSpeed irons, I'll be honest, I didn't really know what to expect. With modern day game improvement irons, these clubs have become so unresponsive. You don't know what kind of sound you're gonna get out of them. A lot of them sound more like fairway woods and drivers, but in reality, this club isn't anything like that. It has a really nice sound. It sounds exactly like, well, a golf club hitting a golf ball. It's not really tingy. It doesn't have an obnoxious click. It's just a good standard sound. When it comes to feel, it's still very forgiving across the whole face. It doesn't hurt your hands, but it lets you know where you hit the ball. It's still responsive. It still gives you a very strong feel. Interestingly enough, the feel is pretty similar to the Vapor Pro combos. I would say that one has a little more feel to it than this one, but comparatively speaking, it's very impressive how much this is like it's more players club big brother. Interestingly enough, the Vapor Pro combos and the Speed irons were pretty similar in how they performed for us. Both Matt and I found that these clubs peaked at about the same height in the shorter irons, so it's getting a nice trajectory up into the air with a soft landing. And the longer irons, about the same distances, but the speed seemed to launch a little bit higher with the long irons, and got the ball up in the air quicker, which is going to be more advantageous to the player using a game improvement club. The miss hits on the speeds were also more forgiving, so you were maintaining your ball speed, therefore you weren't losing as much distance. It'd be naive of me to say you don't lose any distance, but it is a lot more forgiving of a golf club. And additionally, they put in this feature, this fly beam, that is used to reinforce the hollow part of the cavity, and it makes the club a lot more stable on the miss hits, again, making it a more forgiving club for you. If you like the video you just watched, make sure you give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our YouTube page. If you have any questions or comments, leave them below. We'll make sure one of us gets back to you as soon as we can. You can also go like us over on Facebook, follow us on Twitter at PluggedInGolf, or go to PluggedInGolf.com to read more great reviews. I'm Bill Bush. Thanks for watching.